Hello, I'm Demi. I work at CSV doing a podcast. On this podcast, I'm going to be talking about Christopher Wallace, aka Biggie Smalls. He rapped at a very young age, about his father quite a lot, and his lifestyle. He never became a rapper at a young age, even though he wanted to. He started selling drugs and got himself into a lot of trouble and hung around with the wrong crowd. He was born in Brooklyn, 21st of May 1972. He was raised in the poor Brooklyn neighbourhood of Bedford. Biggie was the son of a preschool teacher. Because he was raised by a single parent, he found himself being pulled in different directions. He dropped out of school at 17 to become a crack dealer, which he proclaimed was his only source of income. Hustling was the way to lead your life for a young black man in the area called the ghetto. His career choices involved certain risks to leave his bad life behind to become a famous MC. Biggie did 9 months behind bars and wrote a lot of lyrics the time he was inside. When he eventually got out, he borrowed a friend's tape recorder and laid down some hip-hop tracks in his basement to try and start off his career. Instead of going back to drug dealing, he also had 2 children, one from his ex-girlfriend and his wife, a son named Christopher and a daughter named Tiana. In the neighbourhood, everyone knew he had more than a dice game. He could rhyme, he could show up at any party, he was known to be a nice guy, but people knew not to mess with him. Brooklyn treated Biggie like an ambassador. When he finally succeeded in the MC business, his success went beyond the tri-state area. He won 3 awards in 1995. One of them was an MTV award for the best rap video. Christopher Wallace was undoubtedly one of the greatest rappers of all time and a legend in his own way. He passed away on the 9th of March 1997. He died because he was shot by a drive-by car in Los Angeles. His murder was never justified. Many want to learn more about this amazing rapper, Biggie Smalls. He may be physically gone, but spiritually will always be alive through his work.